And made tense. They have launched their first event that is to distribute facial masks to the public. And today we have a special guest today, the Vice Chairman of National Committee of CPPCC and the former Chief Executive of Hong Kong, Mr. Leung Chun-ying.
Hello, Mr. Leung. 先说说香港的近况,
so we will start our program. So I would like to understand the current situation in Hong Kong. Yesterday was the Mother's Day, but still we saw some of vandalistic events in Hong Kong. And people are discussing their mother and what they are doing right now.
And how was your thoughts about this event?
And yesterday, we did see some young people coming out on the streets and conducting vandalism. Last year, we do see some violence in Hong Kong, and some young people were arrested by the police. Among 8,000 people who have been arrested by the police, a great number of them are young people. But for those people, they're not actually the convener of those violent events. Actually, for some of the key leaders of those events, they are not the people who are participating in the violence, but they are the people who instigate others to participate in this violence. And some people are being brainwashed, and they're engaged in these illegal acts in Hong Kong. And some people are arrested and brought to court and wait for sentence. And for these people, their family members are quite worried and frustrated about their behavior. However, but we could see some of the leader of those groups, and these people, they're actually accompanying their families, but they instigate other people to go out on the streets to conduct vandalism. So actually, they are making use of other people. They brainwash these people and ask these people to engage in violence. And also we found some of the people who are going on the streets, they are fresh graduates. And also we see some people are actually taking important positions in the Hong Kong coalition. Among 1,000 members of the Hong Kong coalition, we invited people from all walks of life. The objective is that we want to hear voices from different sectors. We don't want the same group of people staying in the Hong Kong coalition. So we want people, for example, from different sectors, from the sector of economy, sector of tourism, education, etc. We just want people from different backgrounds to join our coalition. And also we consider people from different age groups so that they can represent the whole society. Actually, for Hong Kong Coalition, we have a great number of people who are representing the younger generation. Some people are just fresh graduates from the universities. At the beginning, we send out invitation to some people, the young people, and they're saying that they used to participate in demonstration. But it's okay for us to bring these people into the Hong Kong coalition because we respect people's rights to express their views.
We
And our thought is that we will bring these people into the coalition and we will discuss social topics so that we can come up different plans for Hong Kong so that Hong Kong can set sail again. So this young generation, they are willing to join our group. The total number of members in the Hong Kong coalition is 1,545, and among which 100 people are fresh graduates. So we are considering people from different age groups in joining the Hong Kong coalition, because for this group of people, they are also members of the public. So we have just passed the Youth Day.
大概的意思就是我们有一个五四前一晚的一个演讲，说我们。And also
in mainland China, we actually have a new word representing the younger generation. So these people have very great ambition. They want to make contribution to the Chinese mainland. I also gathered some questions from Hong Kong people. And some people mentioned that they do have ambitions, but now they're getting a little bit indifferent. So what do you think about that? How can we motivate these people to make contribution to the society? So recently we do see a video that's circulating online in Chinese mainland. They are talking about the ambitions of the younger generation. And right now, we could see some young people in Hong Kong, they are also ambitious and they are willing to make contribution. However, because of the reality, some people are getting a little bit indifferent or even numb to make a contribution. So let's get back to Mr. Leung to understand this issue.
我们请我们的技术再调整一下。我们也好，我又回到了梁先生哈。这个远程的连线看来还是挺艰难的哈。但是我们，我觉得我们这个连线
It's difficult to conduct this kind of a remote conference. Please go on.
我们还在等待。这就是疫情给我们带来的一些挑战哈。
This is actually the challenge from COVID-19, because we have to connect Mr. Leung from Beijing to Hong Kong. Please wait for a few seconds. So I'm just talking about a letter that we received from a Hong Kong resident. And this person actually worked in Hong Kong, and this person used to participate in demonstrations and public gatherings. But he or she is quite struggled because they're quite confused. Because there are a large group of people with different political views, and the society is disintegrated. And they're feeling very confused, and they don't know what is the way out, because they cannot see the future of Hong Kong. They cannot see the link between Hong Kong and Chinese mainland. So this time we want to invite Mr. Leung Chun-ying to join us and discuss the current situation in Hong Kong. And as he just said, among 1,500 members of the Hong Kong coalition, 100 of them are younger generation, and some of them are fresh graduates from the universities. We just want to unite all of those young people and find a way out for Hong Kong.
All
right, let's get back to Mr. Leung. As I've just said, for many people, they're participating in illegal public gatherings or demonstrations. In our work to curb the violence, We have to find a way out for the younger generation because we realize some people are being brainwashed. I believe this happens in different parts of the world. In Western countries, US, European countries, we do see some people being brainwashed, meaning that some people were driven to extremism and they will conduct some illegal acts. Especially in the US and European countries, and this happens to different religious groups. In Hong Kong, we do see some young people are being driven to extremism, and they're developing resentment to central government, the police officers, etc. And these people will bring damage to the society and breach the peace in the society. We have to pay attention to this issue. We have to respect rule of law because Hong Kong is built based on rule of law. We have to respect our regulations and laws. We need to educate our younger generation to respect the law. Some people are advocating that justice is actually going beyond the rule of law, and they are breaching the law in pursuit of justice. But what is justice? This is a subjective view. So we have to do what we can to encourage the younger generation to respect regulations and rules. So actually, many Chinese younger generations pay attention to the Hong Kong dispute and the Hong Kong issues. So can you share some of your comments about this? And do you have some words to the younger generation in the Chinese mainland? Since Hong Kong's return to China, the Chinese mainland has provided a lot of support to Hong Kong. And younger generation representing the future. And the future of Chinese mainland belongs to the younger generation in mainland, Macau and Hong Kong. I hope in the future we can boost exchange between the younger generation in Hong Kong and Chinese mainland. In the past few years, we have the Belt and Road Initiative. There are a lot of events happened, and also we are organizing some Hong Kong residents and Hong Kong students to conduct a field trip in Chinese mainland. Even some French graduates in Hong Kong, they are showing their willingness to work in Chinese mainland. For the economic structure in Hong Kong, we are dependent on our trade of goods and also the development of the catering hospitality industry. And actually, we do have some talents in Hong Kong, and some of them are showing willingness to work in Chinese mainland. And also have a lot of conversation with these people. For one student, actually he's willing to participate in some key projects in Chinese mainland, for example, the aerospace program. Actually, in Hong Kong, it is not that easy for this kind of young students to seek job in Hong Kong. So the only option for him is to maintain aircrafts in the airport. However, if this student wants to engage in the work of maintenance and design of the aircraft, maybe we do not have sufficient job opportunities here. So I would like to encourage this group of people to visit Chinese mainland to seek job opportunities, as Hong Kong is an inseparable part of People's Republic of China, so Hong Kong can also offer job opportunities to people who are coming from Chinese mainland. For the Hong Kong Coalition, they are actually doing their first activity, that is to distribute face masks to the public. Why did you decide to have this activity? So from day one of the outbreak of COVID-19, we started to wear facial masks to contain the virus. So actually, we are one of the front runners in prevention and control of COVID-19. In the past few months, we are actually running short of facial masks, and many people are concerning about this situation. But right now, we are basically contained COVID-19, but we have to make sufficient preparation. So for example, if in the future we see a second or third wave of the coronavirus, so that we have to make sure that everyone have sufficient facial mask. We have some people who are coming from the frontline health workers, so maybe they are working in the production and the manufacturing of facial masks, so they will brief the coalition alliance on the current capacity of PPEs and medical supplies. So they're running a lot of calculation. For example, we have over 1 million students who will come back to school soon. So we will make a calculation like how many people need face masks. How many face masks can we distribute to these people? So we have to understand the supply situation of the facial mask, and we will deliver this information to the public so that they can rest assured amid COVID-19. So this is one of our major events to distribute facial masks to the public. So actually, this is a choice amid COVID-19. And right now, we hear different voices from around the world. For example, some Western politicians, they are saying Chinese virus, etc. I would like to understand whether this kind of a statement or claims will have some impacts on Hong Kong. Well, every day we receive huge number of information. And some people are receiving this information on a daily basis. So for some political figures in Western countries, they're actually making contradictory statements, and this may more or less affect the views of Hong Kong people. So you always talk about Hong Kong should set sail again. So what is the key consideration for Hong Kong to restart? So a few months ago, we saw the outbreak of COVID-19, and later on, we also found some violent events happened in Hong Kong. So we believe right now the key task is to unite our people. And also we found some people, they're quite negative and passive. They're also developing a resentment against the government, the society. And people are also fear about their opinions and voices. So in order to resolve the deep city problems in Hong Kong, we have to find out all of these people and unite all of these people. We have experts from different sectors. They will discuss all of the existing issues, and they will come up with a series of measures to bring instant effect. So by solving all of those problems, Hong Kong is able to set sail again. For Hong Kong Coalition, we have like two key themes. The first one is that we encourage Hong Kong to set sail again. We have to break the deadlock, and we have to unite it so that we can restart. Going forward, we will have discussions with people from different sectors, and we would like to hear the opinions from the members of the public so that we can join forces to restart. So I saw some of the comments from our viewers. They're talking about education in Hong Kong. So what is the consideration from the Hong Kong Coalition about education? So we will not make any comments on education, but we will work together with the government to improve our education. But we have to respect rule of law, and of course, we will publicize this core value in universities and schools. As I have just said, we would like to invite more fresh graduates to join the Hong Kong Coalition so they can raise their opinions from their perspective, so that we can find out whether there are some of the loopholes in our educational system. So we are coming to the end of the show. Last two questions. The first is about the social unrest caused by the extradition bill. And actually, you are doing a lot of contribution in curb the unrest. Previously, you were also saying that you would like to grant $1 million to seize certain offenders. So actually, at different stage of the society, we need to take different positions. So in the past, maybe my public image is relatively mild and gentle, but right now, we saw some people were using violence to disintegrate Hong Kong, and they are making trouble to the society. So we have to express our view frankly and directly. And we need to come up with concrete measures.
Mm.
Well, even though I'm thinking in a rational way, but maybe I'm expressing in a more emotional way. So, for example, in Hong Kong, we have the pro-establishment party. When they're making their speeches and making their views, they're quite gentle. But we need some leaders to voice out their opinions more directly. So now you're 66 years old, so I believe you like to watch movies. Do you still have time to watch movies? Not much. Well, I don't watch a lot of films because I always watch these films on airlines. Actually, I'm quite busy in working. I'm not thinking about my age. I hope I have sufficient energy to make contribution to the development of Hong Kong. I always say there are a lot of things to do in Hong Kong. We are still at a stage of development. For a lot of things that we want to do, but maybe we do not have sufficient capacity to do it. But as long as this kind of task is within my capability, I would like to do all kinds of this contribution and task. So I always tell myself, I have to review what we have done and what we need to do in the future. I always look back to the past, since the reform and opening up of China, and also participate in some key projects. I would say together with the residents of Hong Kong, we do make many important progress, which is quite encouraging for myself. So what is your goal right now? In Hong Kong, we have 7.5 million residents. So we have to resolve the deep city problems in Hong Kong. One is the violence. The other one is the COVID-19. For these two tasks, there are major tasks in Hong Kong, and also it concerns our 7.5 million Hong Kong residents. I believe with the leadership of central government and joint efforts made by the Hong Kong SAR, we will overcome these difficulties. Thank you. Thank you for your time. And just now we just interview, have a quick chat with the major convener of Hong Kong Coalition, Mr. Leung Chun-ying. Just as the development of Hong Kong, actually our video link is a little bit tortuous, and we do hear some valuable views from Mr. Leung Chun-ying. And some people are saying that actually we are a big family with Hong Kong SAR. And also for this thing of our today's program is that even though now we are experiencing torturous past, now in the future, we will overcome all of these difficulties. And Leung Chun-ying used to mention that he used to show their video in 1988 in initiation of basic law, because Hong Kong is our common home, and we will build a better future for Hong Kong. That's the end of the program. Thank you.